What is the difference between a series and a parallel circuit? Hey guys! In today's video, I will explain what is a series and a parallel circuit. Circuits are the backbone of all electronic devices, from the simplest flashlight to the most complex computer systems. Imagine you're stringing lights on a single path in your backyard. In a series circuit, components are connected end-to-end, forming a single pathway for the current to flow. Here is a simple series circuit with a battery and two red LEDs. To avoid blowing up the LED, a resistor is added to the circuit to limit the current. Use Ohm's law to calculate the required resistance. Resistance is equal to voltage divided by current. The blue LED has a forward voltage drop of around 3.3 volts. We subtract the power source, which is the 9-volt battery, from the two blue LED. The rated forward current of a blue LED is around 20 milliamperes or 0.02 amps. The resistance for this circuit has to be at least 120 ohms. Notice how the current flows from the battery through the resistor, into the first LED, into the second LED, and back to the battery. The current is the same through every component. But there's a catch. If one LED burns out, the circuit breaks, and both lights go out. Let's see how a series circuit is demonstrated in real life. Connect the red jumper wire to the positive terminal of the breadboard. Connect the other end of the red jumper wire to the red alligator clip. Connect the black jumper wire to the negative terminal of the breadboard. Connect the other end of the black jumper wire to the black alligator clip. Based on the previous circuit diagram, I will use the required 150 ohms resistor. Bend the ends of the resistor wire and insert them into the breadboard. Insert the left resistor wire into the same column as the positive terminal of the breadboard. I'm going to use two blue LED for this series circuit. One of the LED legs is longer than the other. The longer leg is the anode or positive terminal. The longer leg should be on the left side, since the positive terminal is on the left side of the breadboard. Do the same for the other LED. Make sure the resistor and the two LED are on the same row. Do the same for the second resistor. Connect the other end of the red alligator clip to the positive end of the 9-volt battery. Connect the other end of the black alligator clip to the negative end of the battery. The two LED lighting up show that we've successfully put together a series circuit. Now let's verify the voltage. Turn the dial on the multimeter to the setting indicated by the V symbol for voltage. Touch the red probe lead to the red alligator clip, and the black probe lead to the black alligator clip. As expected, the voltage of the battery is around 9 volts. As shown, the voltage of the blue LED is around 3.3 volts. The voltage of the resistor is around 2.8 volts. In a parallel circuit, there are multiple pathways for the current to flow. In this circuit, the current flows through the first blue LED and the rest through the other blue LED. Since there are multiple pathways, a resistor is required for each LED. Each pathway that requires a resistor has its own calculation. 285 ohms is the minimum resistance required to avoid blowing the LED. Given that a 285 ohms resistor isn't available, I will use the next best thing I have, which is a 330 ohms resistor. Using a higher resistor does the job, but the catch is the higher its value, the dimmer the LED gets. You can get the precise resistor you need by lining up several resistors in series. For our demonstration, the brightness of the LED is good enough. It's time to see a parallel circuit in action. Insert the red jumper wire to the breadboard's positive terminal. Connect the opposite end of the red jumper wire to the red alligator clip. Insert the black jumper wire to the breadboard's negative terminal. Connect the opposite end of the black jumper wire to the black alligator clip. As I mentioned earlier, I will be using a 330 ohms resistor. Bend the ends of the resistor wire and attach it to the breadboard. Do the same for the other 330 ohms resistor. Since this is a parallel circuit, insert the resistor into a different row. Insert the blue LED into the same row as the resistor. Make sure the shorter leg or the cathode of the LED is on the right side. Insert the other LED into the same row as the other resistor. Connect the opposite end of the red alligator clip to the positive side of the 9-volt battery. Connect the other end of the black alligator clip to the negative end of the battery. Both blue LED are lit, which means we have successfully connected the parallel circuit. Turn the multimeter's dial to the voltage setting, the one with the V symbol. Verify the voltage of the battery by touching the probe leads to the battery terminals. The reading shows around 9 volts. Touch the probe leads to the LED. The reading shows around 3 volts. Touch the probe leads to the resistor. The reading shows around 5.7 volts. You can also combine series and parallel circuits as seen in the circuit diagram. There are red, blue, and green LED in a series. All of them combine to be in parallel. If we light them up, you can see the current flowing through the three pathways. Similar to the previous demonstration, we need a resistor limiting the current for each pathway. To calculate the resistance of each pathway, we use Ohm's law again. 250 ohms is needed for the pathway for the red LED. 120 ohms is needed for the pathway for the blue LED. 200 ohms is needed for the pathway for the green LED. Let's connect the resistors and the LED to the breadboard. All the LED are lit, indicating we've successfully set up the series and parallel circuit. We can also confirm the voltage of each of the LED. I hope this video has taken you on a journey through the world of series and parallel circuits. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell so you don't miss any of our future videos. I look forward to seeing you in the next video.